passed over here. Because we encourage evil. And from tonight, you will turn. Somebody there, I said, tonight, you will repent. It says, because with lies, ye have made the heart of the righteous sad, whom I have not made sad. Listen to this. And you have strengthened the hands of the wicked, that he should not return from his wickedness. He's saying, you didn't only do that was wicked. You didn't only get yourself in wickedness. You encouraged other people too. And because you encouraged other people too, that's why the suffering, that's why the evil, and that's why the calamity that comes upon you by yourself. Are you going to retrace yourself? Are you going to say, Lord, I know. Lord, I understand. I know what's happening. I know why I'm suffering. I know the reason for the sorrow. You say, Lord, I knew I did wrong. I knew I'd sinned. All I've seen and come short of the glory of God. And as you come to the Lord, you say, Lord, I'm going to repent. I'm talking to somebody there tonight. I said, I'm talking to somebody there tonight. You are going to repent. What are you there? Who am I talking to there? Wave that hand at me. You will repent. And as you repent, something good will happen to your life in Jesus' name. Ezekiel told the people, he said, you know what? Every soul is mine. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. And all that we see today, they are the messengers of death. Poverty, messengers of death. Sorrow, messengers of death. Sickness, messengers of death. And you say, it's not witch. It's not wizard. It's because of the evil in your hand. But if you will turn around. Somebody there tonight, you will turn around. I said you will turn around. A change will happen in your life in Jesus' name. Otherwise, the absence of the glory of God. Otherwise, the suffering will continue. In fact, Ezekiel was very clear. And Ezekiel was pointed. Look at this. Look at Ezekiel chapter 16. Ezekiel chapter 16. And I'm reading here from verse 49. It says, behold, this was the iniquity. Iniquity, that is a big word for transgression. Iniquity, that's a big word for wrongdoing. Iniquity, that's a big word for evil. Iniquity, that's another word for sin. It says, behold, this was the iniquity of thy sister Sodom. Pride, is that so? It said, that's one of the problems that we have, the pride. And then it says, fullness of bread and abundance of idleness was in her. And then he goes on to say, neither did she strengthen the hand of the poor and the needy. Look at verse 50. And they were haughty. They were proud. They bragged about their sin. They brag about their evil. And that's why the problem has continued. Instead of repenting, we rejoice in wickedness and we rejoice in violence. But tonight, a change will happen. Somebody there said tonight, a change will happen. And then, as we say, yes, I understand. Pride is sin. I understand. Hypocrisy is sin. If my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and seek my face, and pray and turn from the wicked ways. Somebody there is turning tonight. I said somebody there is deciding to turn tonight and turn from the wicked ways. He says, I will hear from heaven. I will heal their land and I will forgive their sin. He's calling you to repentance. And that's why he says in verse 51, neither has Samaria committed half of thy sins, but thou hast multiplied thine abomination more than they. It says, you know, as you look at your life, instead of getting nearer and nearer unto God, we're getting nearer and nearer unto the devil. instead of becoming cleaner and cleaner, we are becoming dirtier and dirtier. Our language, our appearance, everything that we do. And the Lord is saying, that's the reason for the absence of the glory of God. Because it's of purer eyes that will behold iniquity. Look up here. If you're living in fornication, you're not going to retain the glory of God and the presence of God. If you're living in adultery, you're not going to retain the presence of God and the power of God with you. Because you need to get out of that sin. You need to get out of that evil. You need to understand the mystery is because of all the sins you have been living in. But tonight, a change is coming. Somebody there said tonight, a change is coming. Stealing will stop. I said stealing will stop. Adultery will stop. Fornication will stop. All that bribery and corruption in your personal life, it will stop in Jesus' name. And when that happens, look at chapter 18. Ezekiel chapter 18. I'm reading here from verse 30. Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 30. Here's what he tells us. He says, I want you to draw near, and I want my glory to come unto you. But if the glory is going to appear again, if the absence of the glory is going to be turned around and turned over, it says something will happen. Ezekiel chapter 18, I'm reading here from verse 30. It says, therefore, I will judge you, O house of Israel. You know, the children of Israel, they thought, were special people, were favored people, were peculiar people. They thought they could do anything and no judgment. And the Lord said, judgment is coming. In fact, the New Testament says it will start in the house of God. So it says, Israel, I will judge you. But look at this, the middle of that verse, repent. Repent. It's telling us now how the glory will come back. And somebody there, the glory is coming back. I said the glory is coming back. How will the glory come back? Look at this. Repent in Versace and turn yourselves from all your sins, all your transgressions. How does repentance work out in our lives? It is not just I come to the Lord, oh Lord, I've done what I shouldn't have done. You said that last week. I have not done what I should have done. You said that the other time. To repent is to turn. To repent is to leave that sin alone. To repent is to say bye-bye. This is evil. I say bye-bye to that. And this is transgression. I say bye-bye to that. And this is iniquity in the sight of the Lord. I say bye-bye to that. That's what the Lord is saying. He's saying, now there is absence of the glory of God. But it says, repent and turn. Turn yourselves so that iniquity shall not be your ruin. Look at verse 31. Cast away. That's repentance. Cast away. Any material of occultism there, cast it away. Any dirt there, cast it away. Any pornography there, cast that away. It says, cast away from you all your transgressions, whereby ye have transgressed, and make you a new heart. A new heart. Today, old things will pass away. I said, all things will pass away. You will make up your mind. You will take the decision. You look at your life, one item after the other. You say, that is bad. That is sinful. That is evil. And that got me into judgment under God. And because of that, new life has come. I said, new life has come. If any man be in Christ, tell me, all things have passed away. And behold, all things have become new. That's why it says, make yourself a new heart. Then it says, why will ye die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of him that dies, says the Lord God. Wherefore, turn yourselves and live. That glory will come. I said that glory will come. Number one is the absence of God's glory. I come to number two. Number two, the miracle. Everybody shout, miracle. I thought I'll hear you louder than that. The miracle of the appearance of God's glory is coming. I said it's coming. The heavens are now opened. And God is now ready. And God is looking at us one by one. And that person there that says, yes, I turn away from evil. That person there that says, I come to Jesus tonight. That one that says, I realize the reason for the absence of the glory of God. And today, I come to Christ. There will be an appearance of glory upon your life. Give me a good amen. Isn't that what I read to you in Ezekiel? Look at Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 43. Ezekiel chapter 43. And here I'm reading to you from verse 2, verse 3, and verse 4. And he's telling us about the coming of the glory and the appearance of the glory. It will appear to me. I said it will appear to me. I said it will appear to me. It's coming your way. It will appear in Jesus' name. Ezekiel chapter 43, I'm reading here from verse 2. In verse 2 it says, and behold, that means stop. That means look at this. That means gaze at this one. That means pay attention. That means get every other thing out of your sight. Behold, the glory of the God of Israel came. It's coming. I said it's coming. And it came from the way of the east. And his voice was like the noise of many waters. And the earth shined with his glory. Your life will shine. Your family will shine. And everything you touch wants to turn away from evil. Wants to turn away from what brought the absence of the glory of God in your life. And the glory of God appears. His shining will come tonight in Jesus' name. And it was according to the appearance. That's the word right there. The appearance of the vision which I saw. And then in verse 4. And the glory of the Lord came into the house by the way of the gate, whose prospect is toward the east. There is a verse I need to read to you. And I want you to write it down if you don't have a Bible. If you have a Bible, you open to Leviticus chapter 9. Leviticus chapter 9. You see, many people, the understanding they have, extraordinary wonders with the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, they think, okay, I come. And I fold my hands. And I say, okay, God, I'm here. They said, you're doing wonders. They said, you're healing the sick. They said, you're saving the lost. They said, you are bringing joy and happiness. Okay, I'm here. Do whatever you want to do. But you know, if the glory is going to come, look at this. In Leviticus chapter 9. Leviticus chapter 9. And I'm reading from verse 6. Leviticus chapter 9, verse 6. And Moses said, this is the thing which the Lord commanded that ye should do. And the glory of the Lord shall appear unto you. You see that? Moses came to the people. He had told the Lord, oh Lord, show me your glory. But he didn't want to be selfish. That he alone will know, will see, will experience, will enjoy the glory of the Lord. And so he came to the people. He said, the Lord told me to tell you something. And tonight, the Lord has told me to tell you something. Are you ready to hear? I said, are you ready to hear? Glory will come upon your life. Glory will come upon your family. And glory will come in your place of work. And glory will come in your business in Jesus' name. But he said, there is a condition to that. There's a proviso for that. There is something that you need to take a step. Look at that again in Leviticus chapter 9 verse 6. This is the thing. This is the thing which the Lord commanded that ye should do. Have you ever noticed the miracle, how the miracles come? Let me remind you. They had no wine. And Jesus Christ was there. And Mary the mother told Jesus, they have no wine. And then there was nothing happened. Until Mary went to the servants and says, whatsoever he says unto you, tell me, do it. And then the Bible records and says that was the first miracle, because he told them something. What he told them might look unreasonable to some people, unacceptable to some people, unimaginable to some people. But whatsoever he says unto you, do it. And they did. And the water became wine. The water in your life will become wine. Joy will come. Happiness will come. But this is the thing which the Lord has commanded that you should do. And when you do that, the glory of the Lord shall appear unto you. Do you remember that Lazarus was dead? And after the death of Lazarus, then Mary and Martha, they said, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Resurrection power coming upon your life today. Am I talking to somebody there today? Anything that is dead in your body will come alive today. Those kidneys will come alive. I said, those kidneys will come alive. And those tissues and those muscles and those nerves will come alive in Jesus' name. But you know, he told them to do something. And then Martha said, when Jesus said, take away the stone, take away the stone. Christ will not take away the stone for you. The stone that blocks your life, that blocks the glory. He said, oh, you know, 4 days ago, the man died. And because of that, he's ticking already. And Jesus said, Master, didn't I tell you, if you will only believe, tonight I believe. I said, tonight I believe. If you will only believe, you will see the glory of God. But you know, he never raised Lazarus until they did what he told them to do. He took away the stone, and then he came and he said, Lazarus, come forth. I see Lazarus there tonight, you are coming forth. I see the sick there tonight, you are coming forth. I see the oppressed there tonight, you are coming forth. But he tells you to do something before that glory will come. This is the thing which the Lord commanded that he should do. And once you do that, it says, and the glory of the Lord shall appear unto you. It's coming. I said, it's coming. What's that? Number one, miracle. Everybody shout miracle. He has miracle for you. Jesus is a wonder worker. Jesus is a miracle worker. Jesus, he can do a miracle in your life. He can turn your life around. He can heal your sickness. He can deliver you from oppression. He can do the impossible, incredible in your life. But he's going to tell you to do something. He's going to say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. And this is the thing which the Lord has commanded that he should do. And the glory will come. A miracle will come. Not only that, salvation. Salvation. Salvation comes. How do we get saved? If you will believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Because with the mouth,